In this video we are going to be taking a look at some programs that I have made in Python, C#, Java, JavaScript and GameMaker. I have put the timestamps in the description for if you want to skip to a particular part of this video to see a particular program. I have also put a download link in the description to download these programs. First, let's look at some programs that I have made in Python. I have made a program called Money to Cash that takes an amount of money and tells you what coins and notes you would need to make it and gives you a remainder. Note that this is in New Zealand dollars in case they are different in other countries. If you want, you can edit the code to match your own currency. I have also made a program called Seconds to Time, which takes a number of seconds and gives you that time in years, days, hours, minutes and seconds. I have also made a program called Typing Test that gets you to type the quick brown fox jumps over the lazy dog and measures your typing speed and accuracy. I have also made a program called Hours to Time that is like Seconds to Time but takes an amount of time in hours and displays it in years, days and hours. I have also made a program called Pixel Density Calculator, which takes a diagonal screen size and resolution and gives you the screen's pixel density. I have also made a program called Percent Chance Simulator that simulates how likely something with 1% chance is to happen at least once if given the opportunity 100 times. You can update the constants at the top. The more trials, the longer this program will take to run, but the more accurate the result will be. I have also made a program called Ordinal Numbers, which displays the ordinal numbers from 1 to 1000 with a correct 2 letters after each. I have also made a program called Number Words, which displays numbers as words. This program can display a given number or display all number up to a given number. This program only works for positive integers less than 1 million. I have also made a program called Factorial, which finds the factorial of a given number. A factorial is what you get if you multiply a number by all integers smaller than it but larger than 0. I have also made a program called DigitSum, which adds together the digits of a number. For example, 23 would give you 5, because 2 plus 3 equals 5. I have also made a program called Chessboard, which doubles one a given number of times. This shows how quickly exponential growth gets out of hand. I have also made a program called Multiply, which uses a homemade multiplication function which I made using only addition. This only works for positive integers. I then went on and made a program called Power, which uses a homemade power function which I made using only multiplication, using my own homemade multiplication function which uses only addition. This program also only works for positive integers. Now let's take a look at some of the programs that I have made in C#. I have made a program called Countdown, which allows you to pick any date in the future and will tell you how many days, hours, minutes and seconds until that date. It will also tell you total hours, total minutes and total seconds until that date. I also made a program called Aspect Ratio Calculator, which allows you to type in any resolution and it will tell you what aspect ratio that would be. I also made a program called Metric Prefix Converter, which converts between the metric prefixes. I also made a program called Notebook. This program has a list of notes down the left and a button to add a new note. Each note has a title at the top and text below. Each note also has a creation and modification date which are automatically generated. The title of each note shows up on the list and you can click each one to select it. This program automatically saves the title, content and dates for each note to a TXT file and automatically loads them when you open the program. I also made another pixel density calculator in C#. I also made a program called Small Clock, which displays the date and time on its title bar. I also made a program called Smallest Number to contain all factors, which finds the smallest number to contain all factors up to a given number. Note that it is impractical to do this for numbers above 18, because the processing required to do so grows exponentially. I also made a game of the card game Uno in C#, where you play against the computer. In Uno you can put down any card that is the same color or number as the card on the top of the deposit pile. You can pick up a card if you can't go, then you have to pick up a card. You can also put down a wild card and you can choose what color to make it. You can also put down a skip card, which will make the other player skip their turn. You can also put down a +2 or +4 card, which will make the other player have to pick up that many cards. You win when you run out of cards before the other player. Your score will be the sum of the value of the other player's cards. Number cards are worth the number on the card. Skip and +2 cards are worth 20 points each, and wild cards are worth 50. It has a high score system at the end, where if you win you enter your name and it will come up on the high scores list, and if the computer wins it will come up as AI. It also says the date next to each score, and I made a date format form where you can customize what date format is used on the high score form. I also have it say total, high and last score for player and AI in the top left corner, and I have some buttons in the bottom left. Now let's take a look at some of the programs that I have made in Java. I have made a calculator program. I have also made a program called generate random file, which writes 10 million random characters to a txt file. I have also made a program called number base converter, which can convert between any two number bases from 2 to 36. I have also made a blue ball factory. The factory has a windmill that rotates and gates that open and close. It also has a pipe at the top. When you click the create circle button, a blue circle will come out of the pipe, and when you click the create square button, a red square will come out of the pipe. When a shape hits the edge of the canvas or a gate or windmill, it will bounce at the correct angle. If two of the same shape touch each other, they will disappear, and if two different shapes touch each other, then a circle or square will come out of the pipe at random. I have also added a slider to control the speed and an option to change the background color. Now let's take a look at some of the programs that I have made in JavaScript. I have made a clock, which I have used on the New Year's 2017 to 2018 and the NZ Daylight Saving Time Ends videos. I have also made another pixel density calculator in JavaScript. I have also made a program called Power Post Counter. This program allows you to count how many power posts are made of wood, concrete or metal, and it tells you the total and the percentages. It also has plus and minus buttons at the bottom to make the text and buttons bigger or smaller. Now let's take a look at some of the programs that I have made in Game Maker. For some reason, most of these programs don't work on Windows 10 November 2019 update, so if you are using Windows 10 November 2019 update or any of the operating systems on the right as your host, then you may need to use a virtual machine running one of the operating systems on the left. If anyone knows why these games won't run on Windows 10 November 2019 update, then let me know in the comments. In GameMaker, I have programmed a turn-based strategy game called OXTriangle, which my brother invented. This game was originally played on squared paper. This is a very complicated game, and I have made an entire video called The History of OXTriangle, which I will link to, so I won't go into much detail in this video. I also made a game called Sonic Stefan in GameMaker, which I had originally made the maps for on paper. I also made a video called Sonic Stefan Full Playthrough, which I will link to. I also made a game called Sonic Dom in GameMaker, which my brother had originally made the maps for on paper. I also made a video called Sonic Dom Full Playthrough, which I will link to. I also made a program called Computer Expert Quiz. I also made a program called Big Clock, which displays the date and time full screen. You can press any key to switch between white text on a black background, black text on a gray background, and black text on a white background. I have used this program in my New Year's videos. Goodbye.